Recording after the Russia Olympic game. 4-0, you must be absolutely delighted with that result. It was a thoroughly professional performance.
Yeah, it was. It was obviously a difficult pitch. Russia, if you look at their record at home, it's been very good. I think they've only lost three games here. They beat Chorley here, they beat Hensford here. So, causes teams problems. But yeah, I thought we were thoroughly professional the way we went about our work. All the team. As I say, I was before the game and all week probably been thinking about what should we do, changing it, and do we look at it. But, we decided to virtually go with the same side as last week. We made one change at full-back. A couple of reasons, but Liam didn't have the best of the game last week, but that wasn't the reason why he was left out. We are a little bit short in that area, and obviously Wes is suspended now for three games, so just basically to put a bit of protection as well. So make sure that, if Liam would have got injured today, it might cause a few problems going forward over the next few weeks. So we had an opportunity to play well, so we did.
Once again, Matt McNeil led the line brilliantly and fully deserved his goal.
Yeah, his goal was fantastic as well for a guy 6'5" to pirouette like that. You're not dancing on ice, I think, next time round. And to finish like that, it's a great finish. But we knew we were going to have to stick balls in. It was going to have to be ugly a lot of the time, due to the nature of the pitch. That's where, again, I go back to people talk about formations. We haven't played any differently in terms of formation, apart from probably last half hour when we've gone two up top. And we've created, again, plenty of chances, and some of the lads who haven't played a lot of football, like Sir Jerome Wright, are starting to look good. So, yeah, but Matty, again, he's led the line great. And, from a centre-half point of view, it must be a nightmare for him to mark. And then you've got Wildy coming on, Chris Sherman and Jamie Rainford still, sitting on the bench. So, yeah, I'm pretty much happy with what we've got squad-wise. Mm.
Were you surprised that Russell didn't seem to offer much of a threat, really, in the attacking-wise? Do you think it was the way that Chester closed them down?
I think it was the way we closed them. We do our homework. Alex A, probably a little bit of an unsung hero, goes all over the country, midweek, Saturdays, Sundays. He's everywhere, doing a lot of work for us. And I think if you watching games, it's a massive help. When we know what they had, we got the lad up front, Obeng, who's caused a lot of problems. I think he must have got a knock second half, but we made sure we got tight to him and we didn't let him run in behind. We stopped him before he could get running, because he is a danger. That's why league clubs are looking at it. And we knew they would go back to front quite quick and get us turned, but we squeezed them high up the pitch, and when we got it, we tried to look after it best we could. And then we played a bit more pace and wide areas to get balls in. And today we've used our strengths, I think. We've worked and trained on set pieces. I think you've seen that today. Balls that were going in that box today were, I'd say, a million times better than what we've had recently. And obviously, we've worked a lot on throw-ins and just putting teams more under pressure through set pieces and throws, and making sure that we've got two lads who can throw the ball. Let's stick it in their box as much as we possibly can. And if you look back to the Northwich game, people said we were under the cosh. All they've really done was put balls in our box and throw-ins. We've done pretty much similar today.
Mm. You must be also pleased that Levi Mackin scored on his debut as well.
Yeah, well, every time I bring a player to the club, and people question if he's not good enough for this club, and he's not this and he's not that. I think by now people should give us a little bit of credit for the players that we brought to the football club. And Levi's another very good player, as I've said, this week. We tried to sign him in the summer. You don't have a career that he's had and only be 25, 26 if you're rubbish. It just doesn't happen. Lads who play Football League, they've got something about them. And he's come in, hasn't played for 3 weeks. Trained, fantastic. Some of his touch playing. Like Gary Jones, who's not seen a lot of him. Gary Powell, we're impressed in training with his touch and his movements. I think he's come on there today, and what a finish, great finish. And obviously, we missed Michael, who had another very good game today, I thought. And Christian, back in there, people again look at Christian, and he's had a bit of a hard time when he first came, but he's played in three different positions in the last 3 weeks and done excellent in every one of them. So, lads have got to be given an opportunity, given a chance, and if they do that, I'm sure they'll perform. They won't always perform, but that's why we're playing in the Evo Stick League.
Mm-hmm. And Jerome Wright, again, he's been to show touches of class. It shows why you brought him in here.
The lads have got to be given opportunities. I keep saying it's a big club, a lot of expectation, and you know, lads come and Jerome's had a slow start due to injury and one or two other things. Well, he hasn't really got going, if I'm honest, but it's like anything. You know, people have got to be given opportunities. And people have got to be given a run of games. And, you know, you look at, there's a lot of other lads before Jerome who on their first two or three, four performances were never good enough for Chester. But now the Michael Powells, the Robbie Boos, the Michael Taylors, Chris Sims, you know, and all these people, and there's probably more, you know, and now, you know, I would say, you know, fans are looking for them to be the first names on the team sheet.
Yeah. You mentioned about Liam Brownhill not starting today. Alex Brown was also out of the team. What was the situation with him?
Yeah, Ali's been struggling with hamstring problems now probably for the best part of 4 or 5 weeks. And obviously bringing Levi in, giving me the option. And Matty McGinn being fit, freed up the options to move Christian in. We've wanted to rest Ali for a while. You know, because it's not about today, or next week, it's about the next 4 months, and we need our best players and our best squad available to us. And Ali's, you know, been struggling with his hamstrings. I had a good conversation with our physio, Will, on Thursday. He believed a week's rest is what he required, or we'd be possibly in danger at some stage if we kept playing him, of him pulling his hamstring, which, you know, six to 8 weeks. And so, you know, we took the opportunity today. As I've said all along, anyone in that dressing room can play in this team. There's not a lot in it. You know, I've been sitting all week trying to pick a team, and I've started coming down here and gone through it again with Gary. And there's not much in them. There's not much in it between a lot of them. All I know is they've come here today and put another fantastic piece of work in, and work very hard for the football club and for themselves.
I mean, the bench alone, Neil, you talk about difficulty in selecting a team. I mean, it's an embarrassment of riches, isn't it, when you look at the players on the bench?
Well, Gary Jones said to me on Thursday, all the best picking that team. I'm having nothing to do with it, he said. I said, well, you know, you're telling them who's not involved. So, no, it's not a nice thing to do, but that's why you're the manager of the football club. You know, you've got to try and make big decisions and try and get the main decisions right, because it's not just in terms of telling people they're not playing, and you've also got the expectation of the crowd. And obviously, you know, people differed with what I picked last week, but, you know, I'm not stubborn. I don't say I'll prove you right somehow. It's just, you know, stick to my guns and what I believe in. And, you know, I work with these players 2 or 3 times a week. I like to think I know them well. But as you say, to have a bench of what we had today, and I'll be honest, on Thursday, when I said training session on Thursday was excellent. You know, really good training session and real good pace about it and zip about it. Lads trained like they played today. And again, I said to Gary and Gary, you know, put a good squad. We've got a good squad, and if we can just keep them all fit and keep them ticking over, you know, we'll be challenging at the end. And what's good now is I can see it all starting to come together, and hopefully we can keep it going.
What's the situation with Jamie Rainford? I know you're probably sick and tired of people asking now, but I mean, is he going to stay, or what is the latest situation? Because people are going to be asking.
Yeah, people will be asking. It's an obvious question. Well, you know, we'll speak to Jamie again on next week. I think. I don't know. At the end of the day, there's two options. I said it to Shane the other day. I believe Jamie would like to stay at Chester Football Club. I think he sees Chester Football Club, and I'm not speaking for him. You know, he's. I think he sees it as the biggest club going forward. It's probably the best, and that's no disrespect to Halifax or the other club involved. And you know, they're both big clubs as well. But he's here. He gets on very well with the players. He gets on very well with myself. So, you know, it's all about what he wants to do over the next couple of days, 2 or 3 days. We will be pushing him obviously for an answer the next few days, because, you know, I've also got to look at when I'm bringing people off the bench. You know, if I'm unsure if Jamie's going to be here Monday, Tuesday, you know, you don't really want to be upsetting a Sim or a Wild if come Tuesday, Wednesday, you know, Jamie is not here. But from what I'm being told, and I don't know, Jamie's not really showed any interest at this moment speaking with the other club, so at this minute I think, you know, he's going to be a Chester player.
It must be very difficult for him, because he's obviously wanting his best decision personally, but at the same time he knows what potential Chester have got going forward.
He does, yeah, but the thing is with Jamie just wants to play football. And that's the catch 22 here, and that's the conundrum, I suppose, for him. When they're playing as well as what they are, the lads, you know, it's if he needs to be playing regularly. He wants to be playing regularly. I'll be honest, he trained on Thursday, and it was a Jamie Rainford report. He was lively, he was getting shots off, and as I say, goalkeeping coach Lee, he's only just come in, couldn't believe his ability in front of goal. So he's definitely come back a livelier player. You know, and hopefully over the next 2 or 3 days, we'll get a decision, and then we can go forward with them.
That's great, Neil. Cheers. Yeah, many thanks. Really appreciate that. Oh, probably.